Always getting it in your man, DJ Akin Tampa's most connected DJ. Dude, I ain't seen you in a while, man. Yeah. Back on the road again. I see you getting your
DJ
Grizzly
Nike
on.
Backwards, man.
One and only came out here. You know, I like about you, man. Like every time we talk, it don't matter. You be like, yo, let's get it out. Let's get it outside. Let's get it wherever.
Yeah, man, because I don't like doing the sit down. Like, yo, what up, gang? With the album? Nah, we chilling, man. We're going to walk outside.
Right.
By the way, nigga, it's about 1,000 degrees out here, man. We had the Chick-fil-A, man. About to get some, you know, some food, man. You can go to, look, it's real.
Yeah, you gotta give a shot.
Yeah, that's a minivan. They still drop minivans out here, too, man. Yeah.
Getting it in Tampa, Florida. Yeah. So let me just go right here, seriously, because you've been at this. What album are we on right now?
Four.
Album number four.
Yeah.
Is the love still the same as when you first started?
Love even greater now, man, because I like what hip-hop is. It's about to come right back to where everybody, like, really going to, you know, be involved in loving it, man.
Right.
Back to the essence, man.
That's one thing I can honestly say, like, that, you know, because, you know, if you look at the media and everything, it's like game this, game that, game this. But right. I think within all of that, they seem to forget how much you always keep saying, I love this hip-hop thing. I love the art of making good music. And do you think that's something that's been lost, like, right now? What's going on in hip-hop?
Man, I think that it's been lost, but everybody's starting to come. Like, everything in life come full circle, man. And,
right.
Like, we really starting to get back to the essence of it, man. I'm loving what hip-hop is. I love everything that's out. Everything from J. Cole to myself to T.I. New Joints to Drake to even Waka Flocka. I know people be trying to clown Waka Flocka, Soulja Boy, but all that's needed.
Right.
Like, back in the day, it was a Big Daddy Kane. It was Another Bad Creation. It was Criss Cross. It was BDP. All of it is hip-hop.
Right.
That's what people got to understand. Because if we just get all niggas to just spit lyrics, then you're going to be talking about where the party music at.
Right.
We get all niggas to party, you're going to be talking about, I want some real shit. So just embrace everything and let's call it one, you know, just, you know, call it one nation, man.
You ain't gonna sit out here and act like you a student of the culture,
man. You know I know my hip-hop, man.
So now we at the Red album.
Yeah.
So speaking of being back at the essence, who did you work with on this album? Because, you know, I want to ask you, the big thing is, and I take it like this, I think that you are a person who has really appreciated the hip-hop you grew up with in LA. So a lot of times you mention Dre and Sandy. Like, can you kind of explain that, like the mentioning of Dre and how what that means to you, like when you mention it a lot of times, like, Dre, I want to work back with you, or Dre,
man,
we should be in the studio.
Dre really took me, you know, from between a rock and a hard spot and gave me a chance to be something,
right?
Or else I wouldn't even be here talking to you, man. Dre is the iconic. Dre that nigga, man. You know what I'm saying? I can say that on Eakin Presents, because Dre is that nigga, man. And, you know, now I got Pharrell and everybody locked in. It's just a real good look for me. And it's a real good look for hip-hop. Try to, you know, really integrate other, you know, other producers. When you're working on your album, work with everybody. Work with the little dudes, the dude that hand you the B-City. And if you can, you got enough money in your budget, then you work with Pharrell and Dre and Timbaland and Kanye and just make it, a real good blend, man. That's how you're going to get the best, the best outcome.
Okay, so where do you feel that you grew at on this album as opposed to your first, second, and third project?
Man, I'm growing between albums. I ain't growing on the album. I'm just growing in life. It ain't even about music with me. I make the music because that's my job. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going through life every day just doing my thing, man. And it's more of a positive note than anything else. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you this then. Speaking of with, like, the positive and the growth and that sort of thing, you came along too in an era that the mixtape thing was really crazy, and now that records is not selling as much, and a lot of these cats is going back making mixtapes. Do you feel like that kind of is kind of becoming like an overflooded market, or it's like?
Nope, I think that all of us need it.
Right.
Like right now, man, if you can see, like, everything, like, damn near every question you ask is going to come back to the same thing. It's us. Like, I can't be seen on the net or whatever outlet that this is going to be, you know, put up on. People can't drag the Eakin interview if you ain't interview me.
Right.
They can't hear me talk if I ain't on your show. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So we just helping each other, man. You help me, I help you. That's how hip hop is, right? That's what we doing.
Right.
Take from Eakin and Game, man, and do the same thing. Somebody come up to you, ask you for an interview, you do that interview, because they gonna put it somewhere where one person gonna see it. Anybody that see it over one person, nigga, it's all positive. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, if only two people see this, that's two people that wasn't gonna see shit if you didn't do it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So you don't turn down no interviews. You talk to everybody that wanna talk to you, and you talk to them in full, and you just be real, because everybody, we ain't dumb no more. That's what's wrong with the industry and why niggas ain't selling,
right?
Because everybody falsifying who they are,
right?
And you ain't got to be gangster, you ain't got to have shot shit, rob shit, just be who you are, man. You know what I'm saying?
And
for real, man, you're gonna see people like really hold it down, man.
Right. And I really respect that and appreciate it, because every time I've ever talked to you, even when I first started this My Place thing, you was one of the first cats who sat down with me and said, yo, I do it, let's rock out.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? We always kept it positive. So basically now we got the album, we got the Red album about to drop. You got a date on it?
Out is August, man. Just August. Wait on it. Yeah.
Okay, and we got the singles that we're working right now.
Yeah.
So what else is the game moving on? Because I know you've done movies. I know you've got the Black Wall Street, which reminds me, man, the Black Wall Street. Are we working on a complete project with the entire family? Or?
We just doing mixtapes, man. And when something stick, then you know you probably see a project evolve from it, man. But we just working.
Okay. Well, I'm glad you stopped through and hung out with me, man. I really appreciate that. I can't say nothing else, but when I see the game, it's all love.
Yeah.
And the album in August, the Red Album.
In August, man.
You need background dancers or something?
No, I don't need nothing. You watch your assistant, man. See what happened while we doing the interview?
Man, can you get a shot of what the assistant is doing when we working?
Your assistant, my assistant, man. That's just what's going on. That's at AR, man. You know that's Cat. That's he. You know he run. No, you know. You see, he intercepted my man at the 40-yard line.
Right.
But yeah. You gotta watch him, man, because he be around Cat Stacks, man.
It can
tell your assistant, watch out.